Welcome back to the Australian Made channel. Be sure to like, subscribe and hit that notification bell. Today we are finishing our circuit around the islands. Today is finally the day. We're going to make it around, complete that journey. And suffice to say, it definitely took longer than expected with the pit stops we took along the way, but you know, that's alright. We got to experience a lot that the game has to offer. And then after this, I guess we'll have to check out all the internal areas of the island. Every little nook and cranny we can find within the depths of the area. So yeah, there's a lot of the same at this stage, zipping around. Just rocks, a few orcas swimming by again, that was really cool. A few little animals running around and stuff. More turtles, plenty of turtles on this island actually, to be fair. So it's going to be cool when they do let you build the water collectors, because you can just kill a turtle on the beach, build a water collector there, because especially if they're like they were in the forest where they were indestructible to damage from mutants and cannibals. Just little stop points you could have. You always stay hydrated on the go, if you didn't have the flask, that is, which I need to go build. End up losing Kelvin at this point for some reason. He goes right for a bit. So we go our separate ways. We'll meet up again though, don't worry. Guarana berries along the way. They grow on everywhere too in this game. They don't give you much as far as sustenance goes, but you know, they're alright. Put a driftwood there. I thought it was a fucking seal again. I don't know why I kept thinking there's gonna be seals in this game. But I mean, that would be a cool addition. Get the blubber off of them or whatever. Another turtle. A lot of the same in some areas along here, you know? But I mean, they can't have it too different all the time, otherwise just be, like, too much going on. I'll have to come up here and get a drink. Investigate if there's any different berries I hadn't discovered yet. Couldn't find anything, though. Not a turtle. Let them turtles be. End up endangered the way I'm going. Couple kayaks, energy drink, flares, you know, the usual stuff you find with them sort of kayaks. Still very picturesque though. Oh, there's Kelvin. Oh no, Virginia behind me, that's right. Virginia finally caught up to me. She wanted to make sure I was safe. Need to get her a shotgun though, so she's even more useful for me. Night time, I mean sleepy time, not walking along in the dark. Pack up our little tent, continue on our way. Drink at this outlet. More boats with rope. There was a little captain's hat on that one, I thought was funny. Makes you think, where was their, you know, the actual ship, not just their little boats, if they had a captain like that. Thank you. more rope. That's the way it goes. And they could at least have the rope like tied off or something, then you got to untie it to get it. I notice there's a big drop off in the water there, like 2 yards into the water, it just drops off to bare deepness. Kind of creepy. Got a turtle crawling around. There was this mutant tied up here, so I thought I'd get myself some creepy armor. My machete. Three coffins laying here. And again, rope. I don't know why they were they tied up in there. The rope in there raises more questions than it gives answers. It's a cannibal village here, so I told Kelvin to stay put, keep him safe, but I'm underarmed and overwhelmed by how many there are, so I tried to set free that mutant to take him out, but he just got his shit rocked. Thought I'd just try and do my best to loot. But they're persistent, these guys. They want a piece of me. I took care of Big Red there. Played out that fella. But then the guys wearing the creepy armor, sometimes the stun baton doesn't actually work on them. I guess they're protected and insulated. So they take a bit of extra work to do, which is the trouble I have with this gentleman. So I got out the Skull Club, see if I could sort him out with that. Bit of back and forth with him. So persistent. Tried to build a fire because I want to build some bone armor. Of course, he showed back up.
Run.
See there, that bastard cannibal got me, but there was a silver lining. He led us right to one of the hang gliders, so that was exciting to get to bring that down, and we land right back down with Kelvin. Graceful landing. Kill this cannibal bitch, causing me a lot of grief, and then I finally get to burn these bodies and make myself some bone armor. Still takes a lot of time, so everything's sped up in these videos, as you know. Thought it'd be fun to tell Kelvin to carry the radio, so I told him to bring the stereo with us, and I'll carry the hang glider. And we're in the home straight of our journey. Old mate that got me before just climbed up the tree and carried on like a fuckwit, so we just walked on by. Didn't have time to deal with his shenanigans. At this point I could see at the very top of my GPS, the little base from when I went and got the pistol from the, the life raft. So I knew I was very close to the end here. We knew we had to push ahead. More dead orcas. Makes you wonder, are they dying of natural causes, or are the cannibals somehow spearing them from the shore, or what's going on here? Because cannibals don't like going in the water. Again, more questions that need answering, End Knight. Like anyone from End Knight's going to see this, but you never know. Thank you. this is where things get a bit interesting. Because I want to take that hang glider with me, but in the water. Can't swim with it. I was trying to work out a way to push it along. And I thought, oh, I'll climb up this rock face a bit over here, get a jumping start and take off and fly the coast. Easier said than done though, mind you. Attempt number 5, we finally get there, we're flying. I'm not very good at this. Look at my head rocking around. Fucking, my perception goes well out the window when I'm trying to use this thing. It's so funny. But I crash. But it's shallow as fuck here. There's points where you actually walk, sort of jump along the cliff face. So I kept jumping along the cliff face, holding onto the glider, then I have to pick it up, climb up the cliff face again, walk along. Then it was shallow enough to just continue walking, luckily. Deep points would make me drop, but I'd have to turn around, pick it up, turn around. But we're so close now. Look how close we are, people. There's the life raft out there to the left. We're virtually done it at this point. And again, if you've watched this far, thank you very much. Your time's much appreciated. And hit that like button, leave a comment, let us know what you think, let us know what games you want to see us play next and in the future. And appreciate your time. Cheers. Shout out to all of you that come back and watch the channel, watch the videos every day. There's a few of you that are pretty consistent with it that I appreciate. Let's keep having fun with it. Let's try and get 100 subs before Easter. How about that?